Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's your brother Yahya Ibrahim with another prophetic protection. This dua that we're going to study, this protection taught to us as a medicine by the Prophet ﷺ, is a powerful one. It's one that is meant to protect our unborn children from the touch and the harm of the shaitan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow our children to go up healthy, nurtured well, and that they are representatives of their faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and leading communities of righteousness into the future. Allahumma ameen. This dua of the Prophet is about how a husband and wife come together to enjoy each other carnally and enjoy each other in the confines of that which is halal. The Prophet said that if anyone wishes to be with their family, you know, if any man is about to consummate their love with their spouse, that when they come together, they should begin by saying Bismillah. To say Bismillah, the Prophet says it seals the sight of the jinn that may be around us. And this is a really powerful thing. There are three moments, the Prophet ﷺ tells us in the hadith of Imam Muslim, where the angels shy away from us, they turn their attention away from us, meaning that they don't observe us in that sense, out of the natural protection Allah has made with those angelic creation. That's when we go to the bathroom, when we habit with our spouse, or when we take off our clothing and our awrah is exposed. Prophet ﷺ says the angels naturally turn away. But those same three places are where the Prophet ﷺ gives us dua to guard ourselves from the shaitan. إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ. In Surah Al-A'raf, Allah says, they seek to observe you from a place that you don't observe them. And in each one of those same places, where we تَضَعُونَ ثِيَابَكُمْ, where you remove your clothing, where you are intimate with your family, or when you go to the bathroom, all of them have a specific dua where we begin by saying, Bismillah, Allahumma jannibna shaitan. In this particular dua where we're going to be with our families, the Prophet ﷺ says, you say Bismillah, you acknowledge the magnificence of Allah. And you begin, it's as if you're saying, oh Allah, I do this knowing that you are the one who is able to protect us. And I do this because it is something that is pleasing to you. So whenever a husband and wife are intimate with each other, it is a massive act of ibadah, a massive act of earning reward, in the same way that it would be a massive sin if they were to do it outside halal. So we begin by saying Bismillah, Allahumma jannibna shaytan. Notice the sigha, the wording of the Prophet ﷺ is that it is communal. It is both of them that say it. Allahumma jannibna shaytan. Oh Allah, protect us from the shaytan. Don't let him see us and don't let him be aware of this circumstance. وَجَنِّبِ الشَّيْطَانِ مَا رَزَقْتَنَا. And protect whatever you will give us in rizq, whatever child may come of this, protect them from the touch of the shaitan. The Prophet ﷺ said that if you say these three words, Bismillah, Allahumma jannibna shaytan, wa jannibi shaytana ma razaqtana. If you say these three words, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause that if a child was destined to be the fruit of this union, that it will not be harmed from the shaytan and dissuade from the path of Ar-Rahman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to practice this prophetic protection for our future children, for our future generations. And these dua, it shows you that the Prophet ﷺ with these measures would teach about sensitive topics, things that are important for us to share amongst each other. This is a prophetic protection that we make for our unborn children. Bismillah, Allahumma jannibna shaytan, Allahumma jannibi shaytana ma razaqtana. Allahumma ameen. Wa salli Allahumma wa sallim wa zid wa barik ala sayyidina wa nabiyyina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.